The island's capital of Argostoli, where Nick and Elaine want to concentrate their search, lies on a picturesque seawater lagoon. It's a working port and thriving commercial centre, which has managed to retain its traditional character and has a very laid-back atmosphere. Our couple would like to be close to Argostoli and its airport, but not right in the city itself, so we've lined up a property that's just a 15-minute drive away. But before we go and see it, we're stopping off nearby at a landmark made famous by a great English poet.
This is Lord Byron's Rock, and he actually came to Kefalonia in 1823.
Anime poetis to Ophelo?
I don't know, I can't read.
It's quite faded, isn't it? I'm told it translates as, if I am a poet, then I owe it to the air of Greece. So he was very inspired being here. And I know you write songs, because you wrote your wedding song, didn't you?
We both wrote that, didn't we?
Did you?
Together. Yeah, he wrote verse, and then I wrote verse, and then the last verse was joint.
Yeah. Wait to see you walk down the aisle, your loveliness and your smile.
He's very romantic. He is.
How sweet.
Well, we seem to be starting off on the right note, and I'm also hoping that the property will be music to Elaine and Nick's ears. It lies in the small rural village of Miniers, where most residents are local islanders and which has a couple of restaurants. Being just a 15-minute walk to the beach, it also has sea views. And though it does need some work, I think it has the traditional rustic charm that our couple is looking for.
It's cute.
What do you think?
It's really cute. I like it.
Oh, it looks nice. Needs a little lick of paint.
It's on the market for £41,600.
Wow.
OK.
So it's well within budget. I mean, the one thing that it does lack is a second bedroom.
OK.
So it is only one bedroom.
Right.
Has it got potential for a second one?
Shall we go and have a look inside and we can work it out?
Let's go for it.
OK.
I think this 60-year-old village house has potential inside and out, and I'm hoping Elaine and Nick will be wowed by its large veranda, which has loads of room for alfresco dining while taking in some fantastic views. It also comes with a small strip of garden to the front and to the side. Inside, it's basic and slightly dated, but has a good-sized living area, a bedroom, a kitchenette, and a bathroom, both in need of refurbishment.
Here we go, then. Come on in and tell me what you think of this.
Is this the kitchen?
This is the potential kitchen. And the bathroom is through there, and both of those really need updating.
OK.
But I'm told that by spending in the region of about £6,000, you could put in a new bathroom and a new kitchen. So you're still well within budget. So what do you think? Would this work as a holiday home?
Yeah, initially it could work.
It could do. I need to see the rest of it.
You need to see the rest.
Reserve our judgment.
Yeah.
OK. Let's go through here.
OK.
Now, this room, potentially a sitting room or a bedroom.
I mean, this is quite a decent-sized room, isn't it? It's all right.
Yeah.
But if you're turning it into a kitchen diner.
Yeah.
What kind of thing have you done to your property back home, then?
Well, we've renovated the whole place. New plumbing, new wiring, new loft. Everything, really. Yeah.
Kitchen, so you're bathroom. No strangers to a project, then?
No, but I didn't enjoy the experience at all.
OK.
How about this, then?
Wow.
Isn't it nice?
That's an amazing view.
Could you see yourself sitting out here having a meal or a nice glass of wine or breakfast, whatever it might be?
Oh, definitely.
This is nice.
Yeah, it's lovely. It's really nice.
So long-term, you think potential?
Potential, if you can go up.
Yes, you can.
You can?
You need to get planning permission.
Yeah. You'd need to go up. And
yeah, because you wouldn't want to lose this.
Put the bedrooms up there and leave this as a large kitchen and lounge.
And it's quite secluded as well, which is quite nice. I like all the trees and the bushes around it.
Well, I'm going to let you two have a look. Do you want to go and have a look at the other room?
OK.
On your own, digest everything, and then I'll meet you back out front.
OK.
All right.
OK.
I'll see you in a little bit.
It's a similar sized room, isn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, I think it's a bad size. I actually really like the house from the front and the back.
I don't know, it's not doing it for me.
Not at all, isn't it? But then it's £40,000, so...
Yeah.
would expect £40,000.
The well below budget asking price of this rustic cottage on the market at just over £41,500 has made Elaine think again about renovating. But has it been enough to persuade her and Nick to put it on their shortlist?
Wow, coming out smiling. This gives me hope.
Yeah, well, I think considering I was the one that said didn't really want to be doing any kind of renovating and work, the budget that we have, it's £40,000, we can't have everything. It's a maybe.
What would you like to see next moving on from here?
A bit bigger?
Yeah, bigger, inside, land.
But it's going to be more money.
Well, that's all fine, that's all doable. We might just need to go a little bit further afield.
Yeah.
But if you're open to that, you can go and get in the car.
Okay.
Might be quite a surprise, actually.
Yeah.
Follow me.
Okay.
A maybe is a good start. And with Nick and Elaine now so open-minded about both property and location, I've got a good feeling about what we're off to see next. It lies half an hour drive east of Kefalonia's capital, Argostoli, and inland through the island's glorious green countryside to the hillside village of Musata. With only 300 residents, it offers the peace and quiet our couple seem to like, and they wouldn't have to go far to buy their daily loaf.
It's quite a small village. There's not really a lot going on here, mainly residential, although you have got the bakery, and they can deliver bread to your door. So all you do is you leave a euro in a bag outside and they'll come and deliver the bread, so that's quite nice.
Oh, well. Yeah. Two of our favourite beaches are really close to here. Trabezeghi's just on that side and Lourdes is a little bit further on.
So we know this area. Yeah. That's brilliant. And so you know the restaurants that you can walk to in about 15 minutes.
Yeah.
And you can walk down to those beaches as well if you can face the walk back up, that is.
Fantastic! The location seems to be just right, and I'm hoping our couple will also be delighted with what they're about to see.